It's the end of the day with Ray. Canada Air canceled a flight, and at the same time, they canceled their service. So I wanted to do this video because I'm hoping my friends aren't doing the same thing. So let me do my little, you know, Air Canada rant for a minute. So here I am on a flight going out of Toronto Airport, heading back to St. Louis. It's late at night, last flight out. Well, guess what? After sitting on the damn runway for an hour because we couldn't get take off, something wrong with the GPS system, according to the pilot. Later, it would be determined that a failure in the GPS system of the 10 other planes that they canceled that night was an act of God. I'm guessing God's upset of all the stuff we're putting up in the clouds that's causing some problems. I don't know why in the world that would be an act of God. That could be a separate video. But folks, when Air Canada canceled a flight, they also canceled their service. They canceled the customer experience. They made it terrible. The customers are going to remember Air Canada over a terrible experience, not anything that they did well, because they did nothing well. They brought 300 people into a terminal that had already closed. There was no services, there was no food, there was no system in place for that, other than giving everybody some hot Cokes. I mean, they gave you some hot Cokes that they had left in little trays on the plane. But folks, what was really the stickler for this was they decided that they had to get everybody out of the terminal. So as they herded everybody out of the terminal, they gave them a brochure, circled a phone number, said, call us up, get your new flight. I'm thinking to myself, what is this, 1990, call you up so you can get a flight? Why couldn't they just redo our flights and send them to us on our phones? We can download our boarding pass and we can fly out the next day, we're done. No, they forced everybody, all 300 people, to have to call a phone number. And of course, at that time of the night, there's nobody answering the damn phone. So you sit on the phone for like an hour and a half, and then they tell you you're gonna fly out in a day and a half, maybe 2 days. So that made some people mad itself. But folks, they had no systems in place to communicate with the customer that was already upset. And then I'm thinking to myself, what if my 85-year-old mother was on that plane instead of me? I mean, let's face it, she's got a flip phone. You know, she would have been totally confused. I gotta go back through customs. Do I gotta stay in a hotel? When am I gonna fly out of here? Not for 2 days. Oh my gosh, what am I gonna do? It would have been horrific for someone that age at that time of night. But Air Canada, they didn't care about any of that. They just said, call us up. So go back to my mom with her little flip phone, or maybe your grandmother with her flip phone. Here she is calling up that 800 number. What do you think's gonna happen? She's on the phone for 30, 40 minutes, and just as the person says Air Canada, guess what happens? Her phone goes dead. Can you imagine that experience? Where Air Canada didn't put anything in place to navigate their customers through the intersection between the physical and digital world. And I recommend that all organizations remember this. Customer experience is measured when there's a crisis a whole lot more than when things run smooth. And it's easy to give good customer service when everything's run smooth. But when there's a fly in the ointment, as they say, or when your current circumstances change, how's your customer service then? Because when things happen that affect your customers in a bad way, you better raise your service. You don't lower it. Well, I'll end my time with this. Status quo is the killer of all that'll be invented. Don't get stuck in status quo, and don't let your customer get stuck in a shitty experience. Have a great evening.